Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel Study with Dani. My name is Daniel Lottery and I'm excited to have you here. If you're new here, kindly subscribe to the channel and click on the post notification bell icon so that you don't miss any new video. From the title, I guess you already know what this video is about, so let's get right into it. If you haven't watched the first part of this two series tutorial, I'll leave a link so that you can go follow and watch the part one video. This will help you have a full understanding of this tutorial. So previously, I imported these files into my Jupyter lab, and it doesn't only need to be CSV files, it can be any type of files. But for now, it is CSV files that we are going to use. But one thing about the Jupyter environment is also that once you import your file, you can double click, especially a CSV file, you can double click on it and it's going to preview the content of the file to you, which is really nice. But you can't really do much other than just view the content of your CSV file. So if you want to analyze or manipulate the data, that is when you want to use Python. And we will handle that in our next section. So I actually forgot to add that do not worry about saving your work because the Jupyter lab automatically saves your work after every 2 minutes. But if you actually do want to save it yourself, you can just click on this button to save the notebooks. And for you to export your notebook and maybe share it with your friends or colleagues or other people, you can go to File, see this Export Notebook As, so you can export it as PDF and Markdown, LaTeX, and also you can save the notebook as, so you can save it as and give it a name, and also you can open the notebook from different paths or open a new launcher. But let's get right into the sections. So this is already set, our kernel is already set to Python, and the kernel is idle because we are not running anything yet. But you can click on the Python kernel to actually make sure that it's on Python, and you can select the kernel that you want. For now, we are going to work with Python. So to import a CSV file into Python, we need to use a read.csv function from the pandas library. Well, Python has lots of libraries and we'll get to know that later. So the first step is to import pandas as PD. You can just import pandas and leave it as it is, but you can import pandas as PD. So this means whenever we want to call pandas, we just have to type PD. You can name it AF, XT, anyhow that you want, so far as you call pandas as however you have saved this. But typically or usually every data scientist call pandas as PD. So let's execute it, and I am going to use shift enter to execute it. So now I have called in pandas as PD. Right, next we want to read the file part of our CSV file and assign it to a variable called df. Df is the short form for data frame. You can also have any variable to represent your data frame, but usually it is df that is commonly used. So df equals pd, which is pandas dot read. Right, you see it has given us suggestions, right? So we want to read CSV, so it's read underscore CSV. I have typed it in, you can just click it and select it, but I have typed it in. So pd, that is pandas dot read underscore CSV. If it is an Excel file, you have to change CSV to the Excel file format name. So we open the bracket and I want to import this file, right? So the apostrophe and the file name 15_9-f-1, and you still need to bring the .csv, and then we run it. So now our file is saved as df. So how do we view our file. So we go to actually also see the first few rows of your file. You can just go as df.head, bring your bracket, right? And this shows you the first five rows. If you want to see the last five rows, also df.tail, and you bring your bracket. This is the last five rows. And you can also go ahead and maybe if you want to view more than the first five, right? You can type in df.head, but into the bracket, put in the number of rows that you want. So maybe you want to see the first 20 rows, and then voila, this is it. Analyzing and manipulating the data will be introduced in our next videos, but hopefully you've enjoyed the upload and import of data into Jupyter Lab.
Thank you very much for staying with me up to the end of this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and share with your friends. If you have any question or topic that you like help with in learning, leave it down in the comment section and I'll try my best to attend to it. Click on the post notification bell icon so that you'll be alerted whenever a new video is uploaded. Here at Study with Dani, we teach in order to learn and we learn in order to teach. Stay safe. Bye-bye.